Welcome back in Lunch Break. With a vegetable-centric menu in a steakhouse setting, The Exchange brings together passions of music, food, and art in the historic Railroad Exchange building. Chef Brian Houston joins us to make the restaurant's surprise hit dish, tofu with black pepper sauce. Chef, thanks for being here today.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Listen, we are only looking at the kitchen, but if you could, you guys are opening just recently during a pandemic. Give us a vibe for the room and the restaurant and all, because you kind of describe it as a steakhouse setting, and yet you want to remain vegetable-centric.
Right. I mean, right now we've just opened up what we're calling a listening room, which is right on Michigan Avenue at 224 South Michigan. But beyond that, we plan to open this beautiful atrium that's going to, you know, eventually be open for breakfast, lunch, and dinner 7 days a week. So just right now, to get things going, you know, coming out of the pandemic, we're just doing Tuesday through Sunday from 4:30 till 10 o'clock.
Perfect. I mean, you know, you got to start somewhere, right? Baby steps. But I think it's a good first step.
Yeah.
Tell us how you're actually breathing new life into this historic place, right? The Exchange, it's a Burnham building in Chicago, which is certainly notable.
Right. I mean, it's pretty breathtaking for me. And the first time I walked in, I was with David Wharton, and he was kind of approached me as an opportunity to a big ambitious project, I think is what he called it. And when I saw it, I was pretty blown away. And I think once we get that atrium up and going, it's going to be spectacular. I mean, it's really one of the more beautiful rooms in the city. And I mean, in a city that's, you know, beautiful 365 days a year, you know, on those few cloudy overcast days, you can retreat and come inside and kind of feel like you're in a beautiful kind of park setting.
Oh, everyone's going to look forward to it. And remember, you know, what's the old adage? Location, location, location. You have that,
right?
A super cool building.
Right.
And I'll bet with the DMK name behind it, some pretty darn good food too.
Yeah. I mean, I'm so excited. I mean, it's really been great to team up with David and kind of, you know, grab ideas from him, but then also pair them with what I've been doing and kind of that market-driven cuisine.
Okay, I know you have a bread department that is worth boasting about, but we're cooking tofu today. Tell us a little bit about both, let's get to the dish.
Okay, so, I mean, real quick on the bread, I mean, we have a baker in-house that's doing the most incredible bread in the city. You know, this dish that I'm about to make is a tofu dish that we've put on the menu and has really received the most praise of any dish on the menu. We do have steak and fish, and we do have a ton of vegetables, but this is kind of the protein that we like to hit. It's kind of the surprise favorite of many. So I've got these vegetables here that I'm just going to saute off in a little butter. First, I'm just going to start with some garlic and shallots.
Okay.
And then a little chili.
Okay.
And some ginger. The crazy thing about this dish is that it has a ton of black pepper in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it gets a little bit of the spice from the chili, but also from the pepper. And then the one unique dish, and all of us chefs seem to have like that one unique item that, you know, that makes things different that you can't get anywhere at home. So we have this sweet soy sauce. And I'm using it because I feel people that can travel. There's a new H Mart. I don't know if you've heard of H Mart. That's kind of on Jackson and Canal.
I have
that
not,
just opened
but
up.
Real chefs have. Any cook in a kitchen has, which excludes me.
Right. Well, and you guys have the recipe. So you can use either the sweet soy or you can just add a little sugar to it, to the dish. So basically it's the shallots, the chilies, the garlic, and here comes the pepper.
Okay.
So I got a ton of pepper going in to the dish here.
Okay, what's a ton, Chef, according to your standards?
A ton for me is about a quarter of a cup.
Okay.
So I do like my pepper.
Yeah.
But that's an aggressive amount.
And the key is
so basically
that it
I'm cooking.
Yeah, go ahead.
All of this, as you guys can kind of see.
Beautiful.
I'm just going to bring that up.
Okay.
And then blend it real quick.
And when you say blend it, you mean to a blender.
To a blender. Exactly.
This is a quick meal, I'm sure, well served at your restaurant. I mean, if we make this at home, though, this is one we can do if we've got all the right ingredients, right?
Right. I mean, I think, like I said, it's basically you guys have the recipe. Mm-hmm. It's these ingredients. And if you don't have, most people have soy sauce in their refrigerator at home. If you want to make the venture to H Mart, I recommend it. If you don't, just adding a little more sugar to the recipe. I think we asked for a quarter cup of sugar. You might want to add like an extra 2 tablespoons of sugar. And I'm just blending this up. Now you can't hear me. I got this nice sauce. I'm just going to add it back to the pan.
Okay.
And then I'm going to add my tofu. So the other secret to this is there's a place called Phoenix Bean Tofu.
Okay.
That's on Broadway and Argyle, which is a local tofu company that we get our tofu from. And they make it fresh daily. And it's really spectacular. I kind of was raised eating the gumball tofu that you had no flavor and, you know, had a terrible consistency. This stuff is super light, and it really is the star of the dish along with the sauce.
You're giving us so many good insider tips. Chef, I'd love for you, tell us how long that one cooks, and let's see it plated if you could. We're wrapping up
right,
here.
Right, yes. All right.
Don't mean to
press. So basically, it's already cooked a little rice.
Yep.
So I just cook a little rice here.
While you're plating that, Chef, you keep going. I want to give our viewers a little information. They can visit theexchangechicago.com. Oh, and there's a picture of the final product. It's gorgeous. We'll post the recipe on our website, of course, at wgntv.com/midday. Chef Brian Houston, thanks so much.
Thank you. Here we go. I'm just going to throw a little green bean on top.
Let's see it. There it is.
There you go.
Chef, thanks. It looks great and good luck.
Thanks, you guys.